look out for the signs. There's plenty of them at the moment. And a lot of this all comes back to the Kennedy family. So we've just seen that Robert Kennedy Jr. has just announced he's going to be stepping down from the election as the independent, and he's now going to fully endorse and support Donald Trump. Because it's all part of the plan, it's part of the family. And JFK Jr. is a name that we've been hearing about quite a lot over the last 4 years. JFK Jr. is alive, is something that we've been hearing all the time. But when we start looking at the signs, knowing that all this war comes back to the Kennedy family and what's had to go in to defeating the enemy with game theory, with central casting, then we can start making a lot more sense of this. So if we go back to JFK Jr.'s death and listen to Mario Cuomo, who is the father of Andrew and Chris Cuomo, who were best friends with JFK Jr. because they're all part of it. They're all the good guys. Mario Cuomo describes him with this word.
The way we are reacting to the Kennedy thing is a good thing. We're really aspiring. We loved John for what he represented. Those of us who knew him better loved him personally, but those of us from a distance loved that. My son Christopher got off a great line last night on a television show. He said, they were talking about, was he a prince? And Christopher said something like, look, he wasn't a prince and he didn't need to be a prince. He didn't need celebrity. Oh, he didn't need celebrity. He said, no, we do. We are the people who need celebrity. We need heroes.
Why do you think the nation needs it?
People have always needed it.
Through the history of
the
world.
Jesus is. That's what Moses was. That's what Joan of Arc was.
When you say that, someone is going to say, wait a minute, you're not talking about this young man or his father even in the same breath with Jesus.
I am saying, until something better came along, a young person like this, Christopher put it this way, he was not just an example of a great past, he was the promise of a grand future, John Kennedy.
And if we look out for the signs, the introduction music that Donald Trump brought RFK Jr. on the stage to was Foo Fighters.
He is a great person. I've known him for so long. For the past 16 months, Robert F. Kennedy Jr.
My hero. And then we use one more confirmation of this video that's been shared with a book about JFK Jr., which quotes Foo Fighters and My Hero.
So it's been kind of a weird day today. There's been a lot happening. And so last week I went to the launch party for this book, JFK Jr., An Intimate Oral Biography by Rose Marie Terenzio and Liz McNeil. Rose Marie was JFK Jr.'s executive assistant at George back in the 90s. She also wrote this book, Fairy Tale Interrupted, A Memoir of Love, Life, Love, and Loss. Besides this book launch, it was also the 29th anniversary of the launch of the original George magazine. So it's kind of one big event. This is kind of cool. She writes to, you know, who the book is for. But look at this. What does that say? There goes my hero. He's ordinary. Very interesting coincidences.
He is the hero coming back. And there's going to be a lot more surprises when we start seeing how it all links with the Kennedy family. Oprah, a name that so many people hate on. She's part of the inner circle too. Oprah and JFK Jr. will be in charge of taking over leadership of the masses. You can fight it all you want. We can start seeing that the signs also connect when it comes to Oprah and the Kennedy family. Arnold Schwarzenegger, another white hat, married Maria Kennedy. And it was Oprah whose words gave them away.
I pulled off the surprise. The wedding was in Hyannisport, at the same church where I first met Maria's grandmother, Rose Kennedy. It was the biggest wedding that I've ever been to. At least 500 people were there. I knew 10%.
How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love thee with the breath, smiles, and tears of all my life.
I'm Maria.
I, Arnold.
Thank you, Arnold.
Thank you, Maria. In good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, I will love you and honor you
all the days of my life.
All part of the inner circle. Then we start seeing Oprah at the Democratic Convention. We're watching a movie. It's not about politics. If you listen to the words that she says, use some common sense. Common sense says that we're in full control. We're watching a movie because we've been told it many, many times.
Let us choose common sense over nonsense. Let us choose truth. Let us choose honor. And let us choose joy.
And then we can go back to Robert David Steele, who is the CIA director, who tells us back in 2020.
My basic gut feeling is he's alive. And by the way, in 2024, if he were to run for president, he would be 64 years old.
Oh, wow.
Which is a good age.
And says in 2024, it'd be JFK Jr. and a woman of color, Oprah.
I personally think Trump has to win the election by the mother of all landslides and then move into an election that might see John F. Kennedy Jr. as our president, hopefully with a woman of color and maturity. None of these damn children. I mean, I'm sick and tired of children pretending to be authentic black leaders.
And if you listen to what Trump says, he's going to stand aside. He's going to stand aside to let JFK come in.
So I just want to ask Bobby to speak for a little while. I'll stand aside. I'm going to stand aside.
All the writing's on the wall because all these names we've been hating on. Tom Hanks, another name. Produced Parkland, which was the JFK assassination documentary. They're all part of this One Awakening. So all the names that people hate on, they're the good guys. And we're going to see it more and more. People can go into denial, but that is the truth. It all links, and it comes back to the Kennedy family.
With those memories we hold warm and dear, a gentle reminder from his mother, and John John celebrates his third birthday with a soldier's farewell to his father.
It's easy for someone to say, well, I'm going to be me. Well, that's easy when nobody gives a damn who you are. But when somebody has definite ideas about you, superlative ones, in John's case, you will be the greatest. You are the most handsome. You are royalty. You are bound and destined for greatness. Do nothing normal. Do nothing pedestrian. You are better than that and everyone. That's not easy to have on your shoulders. He's the only person we've ever seen have that kind of greatness put upon him. In our culture, where we don't recognize royalty, he was the closest thing we had to a crown prince.
He was the